Now, slack variable, when there are mixed inequalities. What I am saying, slack variable when there are mixed inequalities, like suppose there is less than equal to, there is greater than equal to, and suppose there is also an equality equal to. I am considering all the symbols together for you. Okay, just let me take an example. Suppose z is equal to 40x1 plus 30x2 subject to 3x1 plus 2x2 less than equal to 6, 5x1 plus 5x2 greater than equal to 27, and 3x1 plus, I can write 10x2 is equal to, I am saying, 24. Now, just look at all these three things, okay? When you look at the first equation, you know it is less than. So if there is something as less than, what you will do? You will write 3x1 plus 2x2 plus s1. You will add a slack variable, right? To make the condition equal to as well as less than. To fulfill both the conditions, we will put plus s1. I have already explained to you in the last lecture how does it work. If it is equal to, this will be equal to 0. And if it is less than, this will have some positive value, right? It will have some positive value. It will always be greater than 0, right? Now, look at the second condition. It is less greater than. So 5x1 plus 5x2. Now, if it is greater than, I will put s2 minus ke saath. I will put it as minus, not negative variable. Variable will always be greater than equal to 0. I am putting it with a minus sign. So what will happen here? Sorry. This is equal to 27. Okay. So what will happen here? If it is already equal to 5x1 plus 5x2 is equal to 27, this will take the value as 0. If it is greater than 27, this will take the value as positive only. Suppose if this value was equal to 32. Okay. So this will take the value as 5 and it will get subtracted. This will be greater than 0 only. 5 is always greater than 0, but it will get subtracted so that we again get which value? We again get 27. Okay. I have already explained you this thing. Okay. So it will also always take, this will also take positive value, but it will get subtracted. Right. Now look at the third. What is the third? 3x1 plus 10x2. It is already having equal to. What it is having? It is already having equal to. So you can't add any slack variable to an equal to. Okay. You can't add any slack variable to an equal to. So this will not have any slack variable. No slack variable will come here. Okay. I hope everyone is getting. Just reply in the chat box. There will be no slack variable for equal to sign. Is everyone getting? Okay. Now just look at this thing. Now we have formed this thing. Okay. Now we already know that there are how many equations? There are how many equations? 3 equations, right? And there are how many variables? Slack variables. We know that the slack variables are only 2. So suppose if I want to write it simplex. So what I'll write is x1, x2, right? S1 and s2. I can't write more than this, right? I can't write more than this. Now, we already know if there are 3 equations, there should be 3 slack variables, but we can't get the third slack variable. So what I'll do here is, I'll just put the values. What is x1? 3, 2, S1 is how much? 1. And for the first equation, it is 0. I hope everyone is getting. The second equation, it is having 5. Again, it is having 5. Then it is having 0. And S2 is not plus 1. It is minus 1. So you are facing a problem. Even if you try to form an identity matrix, what is the problem? This is coming out to be minus 1. And for the identity matrix to be possible, this should be plus 1. It should to form an identity matrix, this should always be plus 1. One more issue is that since there are three equations, even though we are not able to get 3 slack variable, we should be very sure for 3 equations, identity matrix should be of 3x3 order. Okay. Identity matrix should be of 3x3 order. So we are facing 2 difficulties. First is this is minus. Second issue is this is not having any slack variable, right? I hope you all are clear with this thing what I'm saying. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll just take it further and just I'll try to explain. See, what I have got x1, I have got x2, I have got s1, I have got s2. I'll just give me a second. One second. What were my equations? I just need to see. Give me a second. What are my equations? What are the equations? Yeah, 3x1 plus 3x2. So see, what I have got x1, I have got x2, I have got s1, I have got s2. Now what I have to do, since this is not this second one, just give me a second. You can see, since this second equation, where is that second equation? Yeah. This second equation, I have to rewrite it. How do I have to rewrite? 5x1 plus 5x2 minus s2. But since it requires an identity matrix to start with, I will introduce a variable which is called as artificial variable. See, slack has got some significance. It tells us whether the value is greater than, we subtract it. If the value is less than, we add it. But since this variable is required to be added, we can see this variable is only required to be added to initiate the solution. Since this will give the coefficient as 1, I hope you can see. We are adding plus a1. This is artificial variable. Since this will give the coefficient 1 and we are adding it, okay? We are adding it and this will give the coefficient 1. This is done only to initiate the solution. Now if I look at the solution, it will be x1, x2, s1, s2, a1. I hope you can see. Now what I'll do is I'll put the value. What is the value? 3, 2, 1, 0. What is the value of a1 in the first equation? It is equal to 1, right? Now if you look at the second equation, it is 5, right? 0. This is a minus 1. No, so sorry. I did a mistake. So sorry. First equation is having what? 3, 2. You can see at the first equation. So sorry. What is the first equation? 3, 2, 1, 0. And this is not there in the first equation. This will be 0. So sorry. This will be 0 in the first equation. Now we will look at the second equation. 5. S1 will be how much? S1 will be 0. This will be minus 1. And this will be 1. Right? This will be 1. Now we have completed, at least we have formed two identity rows. See, we have formed 1, 0, we have formed 0, 1. Now we can proceed, but before proceeding, we have to see at the third equation. What was our third equation? 3x1 plus 10x2. Now just look at this. This is having, third equation was 3x1 plus 10x2 is equal to 24. So we can't add any slack variable. But since there are three equations and the identity matrix should be of the order 3 by 3, okay, identity matrix should be of the order 3 by 3. We have to add one more variable to start the iteration. We have to add one more row. So what I'll do here is 3x1 plus 10x2. I'll add another variable a2. Why I'm adding? Because I can't add slack variable. It is equal to, so I can't add slack variable in plus or minus. If it would have been minus, this would not help. This would not have helped my cause. So what I have to do? Whatever is the equation, since it is only with equal to, I have to add another artificial variable. I am adding which variable? Artificial variable. So I am getting another variable here, which is a2. Okay, now the value of a2 in the first equation is 0. In the second equation is 0. Now I know the third equation coefficients. 3, 10. So I'll write 3, 10, 0, 0, 0, 1. Now you can see 3 by 3 matrix, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. So the solution will start with three variables. Now these variables are not slack variables. The solution will start with variables which are forming, always remember, solution, iteration starts with variable which form identity matrix. Now here, which are the terms which are forming identity matrix? S1. Next, A1. Just see the sequence. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Then A2. Okay. So now if I have to write something here to iterate the solution, I will write S1, A1, A2. Okay? I hope you have understood till here. Now I need to write Z also. Z was what? 40X1 plus 30X2. Now there are how many slack variables? 2. So it will have 0S1 plus 0S2, right? But there are also some variables which are artificial, which are artificial. So to write artificial, we write, to add artificial variable, we write minus MA1 minus MA2. Why do we write minus M? Now I will let you know what is this minus M. Okay. I am writing Z as, dekho, 40X1 is okay. 30X2 is okay. Plus 0S1, we don't want it to contribute. It will not contribute. But if suppose there is something which is there in the solution, after I complete my iteration, suppose in the final iteration, if I am getting A in my final iteration, if I am getting artificial variable in my final iteration, that means I am giving some variable which was not actually there in the system. See, S1 and S2 were there in the system. Just remind yourself that S1 and S2 were there in the system. How they were there in the system? They were there as less than or greater than. But since these variables are not there in the solutions, this variable will cause penalty. Ye jo variable hai na, this variable will cause penalty to the company, okay, or to the manufacturer. So this type, matlab, isko bolte hai very big penalty. M is a very large integer. Very, very large integer. So suppose I was going to get a profit, okay, M is a very large integer value, okay? Or it can be any value, it can even be a fraction value. Okay, so if suppose I get M into the solution, suppose karo A solution mein reh gaya, final solution mein A1 aya 1 aur A2 aya 2. So agar ye solution mein reh gaya, to company ko bahut bada phatka lagne wala hai. Company will get a huge penalty. Matlab sirf isse kaam nahi hone wala. Company ko ye value infinitely large hai. Suppose karo 1 crore hai. So 1 crore into 1 will be equal to minus 1 crore. So company agar suppose करो 3 crores का profit उठाने वाली थी, ठीक है, तो minus 1 crore की penalty लगेगी, क्योंकि A1 क्या हो गया, solution में रह गया. I hope you are getting. So this method is called as penalty cost method. This method is called as, ये जो method है ना, जिसमें हम क्या introduce करते हैं, जिसमें हम artificial variable introduce करते हैं, ये method को हम कहते हैं, we call this method as penalty cost method. इसका एक और नाम है, I think you have already learned it in maths, if you have not learned it here, big M method भी बोलते हैं, ठीक है, this is called as penalty cost method and this is called as big M method. So we can be sure, first is basic simplex method where all the signs were less than equal to, okay, when all the signs are less than equal to, which method do we use? We used simplex method where we only add the variable, slack variable is added and we get the solution. Suppose if there is something which is less than equal to and equal to, if we are getting this two, we are not having any greater than equal to. Here also we are, since this is equal to, we have to introduce an artificial variable, right? So this will go to which class? This will go to penalty cost. Okay. If there is something which is greater than equal to, less than equal to, then also it will go to which class? This will go to penalty cost. If there is something which is greater than equal to, less than equal to, then also it will go to which class? It will go to penalty cost. If there are all equations with only equal to, then also it will go to which class? Penalty cost. So I hope you have understood, when there are mixed equations or inequalities, just let me complete. When there are single type and all types are less than equal to, we solve it by simplex. Okay. Basic simplex method. When there are mixed inequalities. Okay. And equal to also, or suppose there is, one second, there is mixed inequality, and suppose with mixed inequality you are also having, or you are having equal to together, okay, any kind, when we are having mixed inequality, matlab greater than equal to, less than equal to, and equal to, so which method do we use? We use big M method, and which is also called as penalty cost method. These are the two methods which come in the exam. These questions are compulsorily coming in the exam. One is based on simplex and another is based on big M or penalty cost. Has everyone understood?